Good morning, all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today, I'm dealing with my lecture 4, that is magnetic circuits and inductance. So in this, first, we will start with the magnetic circuits. And second thing is, we will learn about the inductance, what is the self-inductance, what is a mutual inductance, and what is the inductance of a toroid, inductance of a solenoidal coil, and coaxial cable. And based on these concepts, we will do few numerical examples. So let me start with the concept of magnetic circuits. Now, a magnetic circuit is a closed path of magnetic lines of force through one or more materials. That is, if you see the first figure, figure A, it is nothing but an electrical circuit. That means there is an voltage source, supply voltage of E with the plus or minus terminals. And there is a resistance R, and this is a closed circuit, and there is a flow of a current I inside the circuit. So this circuit, we will call it as electric circuit. We have already done. Now what is there in a magnetic circuit? Now again, magnetic circuit also is a closed path of magnetic lines of force through one or more material. That means, this is also a closed path with a resistance R, and there is an EM, that is the voltage source. Now, in this closed path, instead of the current I, in case of magnetic circuit, we will represent it as flux phi. So, inside this circuit, there is a generation of flux phi. So how there is a generation of the flux phi? If you see this diagram, you will come to know. That means there is a material, magnetic material, and a wire is winded with the material, any material, conducting material. Then there is a flow of a current I inside this wire, and there are n number of turns, and there is a flow of a current I inside this, and there is a generation of flux phi, that means a line of force through this material. So you can see here there is a flux phi, generation of the flux phi in this direction because of the current I, and it has n number of turns. So based on this concept, that is for the magnetic circuit, there will be a current I, there is a n number of turns, and there is a generation of the flux phi. Using these three concepts, we can define the inductance or the mutual inductance in the second concept. But in this, we are learning the magnetic circuit. So in the magnetic circuit, the very important concept is generation of flux, that is phi. So this is very simple magnetic circuit. Now, we will do the study of this magnetic circuit with comparing the electric circuit, what we have done in our previous studies. That is, electric circuit and magnetic circuit. So in electric circuit, that is, in the circuit, the current actually flows, that is, there is a movement of electrons. So if there is a movement of electrons, we will call it as an electric circuit. But in case of magnetic circuit, due to the magnetomotive force, the flux will be established and does not flow in the sense in which current flows in case of electric circuit. That means there is a generation of the flux, it will be established, but it does not flow in the sense how it will flow in case of electric circuit. Now we will see the second difference. The energy must be supplied to the electric circuit to maintain the flow of a current. That is, in case of electric circuit, energy should be supplied to maintain the flow of a current. But in case of magnetic circuit, the energy is required to create the magnetic flux, but it is not required to maintain it. That means we need the energy to create the magnetic flux, but it is not required to maintain. We are not maintaining like how we are maintaining in case of electric circuit, that is the supply energy. In case of magnetic circuit, the energy is very much necessarily required to create the magnetic flux. Now, third one, let us see the difference. That is, the resistance and the conductivity are independent of current density under constant temperature. That is, both the resistance as well as conductivity are independent, but they may change because of change in the temperature. But in case of magnetic circuit, there is reluctance. The reluctance and permeance and the permeability, they are all dependent on the flux density. So in case of magnetic circuit, we will calculate the flux density, and all these terms, that is equivalent terms with respect to electric circuit, that is reluctance, permeance and permeability, they are all dependent on the flux density, that is magnetic flux density. Now fourth one is, the electric lines of flux are not closed. They start from positive charge and end on a negative charge. So in case of electric lines, the flux is not at all closed, but instead it will start from the positive charge and it will end at the negative charge. But in case of magnetic circuits, the magnetic lines of flux are closed lines. They are always a closed line. So you have seen the circuit, they are all closed lines. And this is how we will define the magnetic flux and the magnetic circuit. So the very important concept in this is, what is the change that we are seeing in case of magnetic circuit with respect to electric circuit. So we have seen so many concepts in case of magnetic circuits and so many basic laws, and using those laws in case of magnetic circuit as well as in case of electric circuit, now we can clearly differentiate what an electric circuit contains and what a magnetic circuit may contain. So I have given in the form of a table, that is electrical and magnetic analogies. So left one, that is first column, is they are all case descriptions, and these are all, second column are equations in electrical case, and third one is in magnetic case. Now let us see one by one, and we can easily differentiate between electrical and magnetic fields. First one, field equation. So we have done a field equation, that is electric field intensity capital E is equal to minus del V, but in case of magnetic field, H is equal to minus del into Vm. Now what is the potential difference between A and B in case of electrical field? That is VAB is equal to integration over the period or over the line from A to B, E dot dl. In case of magnetic field, V is equal to integration from A to B, H dot dl. Here it is E dot dl and here it is H dot dl. So we have done these basic laws in case of electric field as well as in magnetic field. Now Ohm's law, What is Ohm's law in electric field? J is equal to sigma V, or else V is equal to IR. So in case of magnetic field, B is equal to mu into H, or Vm is equal to phi into S. That is the flux into the surfaces. Next one, the current or the flux density. Now we will write I is equal to J dot ds in case of electrical, and in case of magnetic, we will write phi is equal to B dot ds over an integration of S. So J dot S in electrical, B dot S in case of magnetic. Now, what is EMF or MMF? EMF we will measure in electrical case, and we will call same equivalent in case of magnetic field as MMF, magnetomotive force. And electromotive force EMF is V is equal to the integration of E dot dl for a closed path, or else we will write it as EL. And in case of magnetic field, we will write Vm is equal to H dot dl for a closed path, or else HL. Now, the important one is resistance in case of electrical field is equal to, or it is similar to, the reluctance in case of magnetic field. That is, resistance, we will denote it as capital R, is equal to D divided by sigma into A, and S is equal to, we will define reluctance as S. S is equal to D divided by mu into A, where mu as well as sigma are a constant, A is the area and D is the distance. So this is resistance, or else reluctance. Now the last one, that is closed path integral in the field, that is integration of, for a closed path, E dot dl is equal to zero, and in case of magnetic field it is H dot dl is equal to n into I, where n is the number of turns and I is the current. So this is how we can differentiate an electric circuit as well as a magnetic circuit, and these are all the analogies between those two and important equations which can be differentiated easily between electrical as well as magnetic fields. Now, based on this concept of magnetic circuit, next we will see about the inductance. Now, what we mean by inductance, what is a self-inductance, what is a mutual inductance, and application in toroidal coil, solenoidal coil, or a coaxial cable, all these things we will see now. Now, inductance. Inductance is nothing but the ratio of total flux linkage to the current flowing through the circuit. That is, in the circuit, what we have seen, in this circuit, the inductance L is equal to the total flux is phi, that is flux linkage, divided by current in the circuit is capital I. So phi divided by I, we will call it as an inductance. So since it is having a n number of turns, the definition of inductance includes n also. That is, the inductance is also known as a self-inductance of the circuit. We will call an inductance a self-inductance as the flux produced by the current flowing through the circuit links with the same current. That's what we have seen in the circuit diagram. There is a generation of the flux because of the current flowing through the circuit in the same circuit. So current I in the circuit, generation of the flux phi in the circuit, along with the number of turns n, we will define it as self-inductance, and we will denote it as capital L. The self-inductance capital L is equal to n into phi divided by capital I. So this is how we will define the self-inductance. So inductance is flux divided by Correct. Phi divided by I. Next we will see mutual inductance. So as the name itself suggests, mutual. So it is also very much similar to the concept of self-inductance only. That is phi divided by I, flux linkage divided by current. But the difference is, the mutual inductance is the ratio of flux linkage of circuit 1 to the current in the circuit 2. So how many circuits are there? There are totally 2 circuits. And since there are 2 circuits, there is a generation of current, that is both currents, I1 and I2, let us say. And there are 2 fluxes, phi1 as well as phi2. Now, the flux linkage of circuit 1 divided by current in the circuit 2, we will call it as mutual inductance, or else current in the circuit 1 as well as flux in the circuit 2, if you take, that is flux in the circuit 2 divided by current in a circuit 1 is also called as mutual inductance. That is, in the previous equation, we will either write it as phi1 divided by I2 or as phi2 divided by I1, because there is I1 and I2 for 2 circuits, along with that phi1 and phi2 for both the circuits. So we will write it as M12 is equal to N2 into phi12 divided by I1. That is flux linkage of the circuit 1 to the current in the circuit 2, or else flux linkage in the circuit 2 divided by current in the circuit 1. So whichever you take, the terms will remain same. That is, whether it is M12 or if it is when M21, both are same. That means we will equate, both are equal. M12 is equal to M21. Next one. Now, based on the concept of self-inductance as well as a mutual inductance, now we have some of the applications as toroidal coil, solenoidal coil, as well as a coaxial cable. Now, all these things we have done in our previous studies, and we have derived the equations also. That is, first one, inductance of a toroid. So inductance of a toroid is, if we consider a toroidal coil with a radius rho naught, then the field intensity H is given by, H is equal to N into I divided by 2 pi rho in A phi component. That is, N represents the number of turns, I represents the current I, and the rho represents the radius of the toroidal coil, of the toroid. So we have already derived the equation for H. Then we will write B is equal to, we know that B is equal to mu into H, and hence we will write mu naught into Ni divided by 2 pi rho. That is the value of B, flux. Now we know both H value as well as B value for a toroid. Then if the dimensions of the cross section are small compared with the mean radius of the toroid rho naught, then the total flux is phi is equal to mu naught Ni S divided by 2 pi rho. That is, the flux phi, we will define it as B value into S, where capital S is the cross-sectional area. So if we consider the total cross-sectional area as capital S, then the flux linkage, total flux phi, we will define it as mu naught Ni into S divided by 2 pi rho naught. So if I know the value of phi, then it is easy for me to calculate the inductance, because I know that inductance L is equal to inductance L is equal to N into phi divided by I, N into flux by current. So here I have calculated the flux phi, then the inductance capital L is given by N into phi divided by I. So mu naught as it is, N into N will become N square, yes, as it is. And since it is a divided by I, the I and I will get cancelled, that is the current terms. So I will get inductance L as L is equal to mu naught N square, yes, divided by 2 pi rho, where N is the number of turns, S is the cross-sectional area, and rho is the radius. So this is how we will define the inductance of a toroid. Toroidal coil inductance L is mu naught N square S divided by 2 pi rho naught. Now with the concept of toroid, we can easily write the equation for solenoidal coil also. That is, L is equal to total flux linkage divided by total current. Then for solenoid it is phi divided by I, and we know the value of phi as mu N square Ia divided by L. Phi value in case of solenoid we know that mu N square Ia divided by L, and inductance L is phi divided by L, N into phi by L. So we will write this as current I will get cancelled, and we will get this as L is equal to mu N square A divided by L. So L is equal to N phi by I. So we have used that to derive the equation for solenoid also, and we will get it as mu N square A divided by L, where N is the number of turns, A is the area, cross-sectional area, and L is the length of the solenoid. So this is how we will derive the equation for solenoid. Toroid we have done, solenoid is done. And next one is a coaxial cable. Inductance of a coaxial cable. So this is the coaxial cable, where A is the inner radius and B is the inner radius of the outer ring. So we know that in case of coaxial cable, phi is equal to, flux is equal to mu naught I d divided by 2 pi ln of B divided by A. B is the inner radius of the outer ring, A is the radius of the inner ring, I is the current, and D is the distance. So we know L is equal to total flux linkage divided by total current. So flux linkage divided by current, phi divided by I, then I and I will get cancelled, numerator as well as a denominator. Then inductance L is equal to mu naught D divided by 2 pi ln of B divided by A into when. So this is how we will define the value of inductance. Now we can define the inductance with an energy point of view also, as L is equal to 2WH divided by I square. Where I is the total current flowing in the closed path, and WH is the energy in the magnetic field produced by the current. So So I is the total current and WH is the energy in the magnetic field. Then 2 times of energy WH divided by I square, current square, will give you the inductance in terms of energy. So we have seen applications and how to calculate the inductance L. Now we will do few numerical examples for all the applications what we have done. Now let us take the first example as a coil of 500 turns is wound on a closed iron ring of mean radius 10 cm and cross section area of 3 cm square, full stop. Find the self inductance of the winding if the relative permeability of iron is 800. For this question, first we will write the given data. Now looking at the numerical, that is, it is wound on a closed iron ring. There is a coil, it is wound on a iron ring. Hence, it is a numerical on toroidal coil. And we will write the given data first. That is, mu r is equal to 800. Mu r is equal to 800. A is equal to 3 centimeter square area. R, radius is 10 centimeter. And N, number of turns are 500. So we will use the equation. Inductance of a iron toroid is given by L is equal to mu N square A divided by 2 pi R. And mu value is mu naught into mu R into N square into capital A divided by 2 pi r. Substitute the values. Mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Mu r value they have given as 800 into the number of turns n is equal to 500 square and the area A is equal to 3 centimeter square. That is nothing but 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square, and we will write here 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by 2 pi r. 2 pi r radius is 10 centimeter, hence 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. I have substituted all the values here and calculated the value of L, that is inductance in millihenry. We will get it as 0.12 or as 120. Next one, for a solenoidal coil, the numerical related to solenoid, that is, calculate the inductance of a solenoid of 200 turns wound tightly on a cylindrical tube of 6 centimeter diameter. The length of the tube is 60 centimeter and the solenoid is in here. We need to calculate the inductance of the solenoidal coil. First, we will write the given data, that is for a solenoidal coil. Since they have given it is in air, mu is equal to mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. N, number of turns as 200. The diameter they have given, 6 centimeter diameter. And length is length of the tube is 60 centimeter. So since they have given the diameter D, we will calculate the radius, that is D by 2. We will get it as 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 meters, and L is in centimeter, hence we will write it as 60 into 10 to the power minus 2 meters. Now we know the equation of inductance of a solenoidal coil, that is capital L is equal to mu N square A divided by L. Inductance of a solenoid, and we will substitute the values of L, that is all the values we will substitute to calculate the value of L. Mu is equal to mu naught is equal to 4 pi 10 to the power minus 7 N square, N is equal to 200 square, and area is pi r square, because they have given the radius. So area is pi r square. Pi as it is, r square, r value is 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. So we'll substitute pi as it is into 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole square divided by L. L is length is 60 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Substitute. And then you calculate the value of L. We'll get L is equal to 0.2368 millihenry is the value of self-inductance of a solenoidal coil. Let us see third example on coaxial cable, that is calculate the inductance of a 10 meter long coaxial cable filled with a material for which epsilon r is equal to 18, sigma is equal to 0, mu r is equal to 80, full stop. The external and internal diameters of the cable are 1 millimeter and 4 millimeter respectively. We need to calculate the inductance of a 10 meter long coaxial cable. So we have seen the equation for inductance of a coaxial cable. First write the equation and write the given data. Write the given data. Length of the cable is 10 meter. Epsilon r is 18. Mu r is equal to 80. Sigma is equal to 0. R1 R2. R1 is 1 millimeter as well as 4 millimeter. Hence, we can write R1 and R2 as 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, and R2 as 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, because they are the diameters they have given, internal as well as external diameters, but we need radius, hence divide by 2. 1 by 2 is 0.5 and 4 by 2 is 2 millimeter values. So we have written in terms of meter, and we will substitute in the equation of L, that is L is equal to mu naught mu r L divided by 2 pi into ln of R2 by R1. Substitute mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is 80, L length is 10 meter divided by 2 pi into ln of R2 by R1. R2 is 2 into 10 to the power minus 3, and R1 is 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Now substitute and calculate the value of n, and you will get it as 0.22. The inductance value you will get it as 0.22. Now today we have seen the magnetic circuit along with the inductance, self inductance and the mutual inductance, along with that some applications and related numericals. And let us answer few quiz questions. First one, in magnetic circuit, the property by which the flux passage is affected is referred as. So which is the term is in magnetic circuit? Is it resistance, reluctance or reactance? Yes, the answer is option B, reluctance is the term in magnetic circuit with which the property, the flux passage is affected. That is, it is very much similar to the resistance what we will measure or calculate in electric circuit. The equivalent is reluctance in case of magnetic circuit. Second one, define mutual inductance. So we have already seen what we mean by mutual inductance. For a mutual inductance, there should be two circuits, and both the circuits are having a currents as I1 and I2 and flux as phi1 and phi2. Then phi1 by I2 or else phi2 divided by I1. Flux in one circuit divided by current in another circuit is called as mutual inductance. Correct? Flux in one circuit divided by current in another. That is the flux linkage of one circuit to the current in the another circuit, we will call it as mutual inductance. So these are the concepts which I want to cover today. That is, we have started with a magnetic circuit. What is the difference between the magnetic circuit and the electric circuit? Then we have done the inductance, in that self-inductance, mutual inductance, and some of the applications as a toroid, solenoid, coaxial cable. And we have also seen how to express the inductance in terms of energy stored. And we have done some example numericals. So that's what I want to cover today. Thank you all. Thank you very much.